In this problem, we start with the observation of a 410 nanometer photon emitted from a hydrogen gas sample. In part A, we want to find the energy of this photon, and then in part B, we're going to figure out what the electron transition was that caused the emission of this photon. So the energy of a photon, that's Planck's constant multiplied by the frequency, E equals HF. But we can replace the frequency with C over lambda and get HC over lambda. The reason we can do this is because the speed of a wave is given by the product of the frequency and the wavelength. I wrote the speed as C there because this is light and it travels at the speed of light. So you solve for F and replace it with C over lambda. And I'll post a link to the video where this was derived, but we have a very convenient approximation for HC. We can write this as approximately 1240 EV nanometers. And I did this because my wavelength is given in nanometers and I want the energy of the photon in EV. So the nanometers cancel out and I get 3.02 electron volts. All right, so for a photon with 3.02 electron volts to have been emitted from this hydrogen sample, an electron must have dropped by 3.02 electron volts as it transitioned from one energy level to the next. And we have a visualization of the energy levels for the hydrogen atom over on the right. That's given by the formula negative 13.6 EV over n squared, where n is the state number for the electron. And the first four of these are written into the diagram. All I did was sub in n equals 1, 2, 3, and 4. E1 is just negative 13.6 EV divided by 1 squared, which is negative 13.6 EV. If I divide by 2 squared instead, I get negative 3.40 EV, and so on. And now our job is to figure out what must have been the initial and final states for this electron in order to produce a photon with 3.02 EV of energy. And there's a major point here to simplify the search. I see that the transition definitely isn't down to the ground state, because the lowest energy transition down to the ground state involves a drop of more than 10 electron volts of energy. Well, that would be way too energetic of a photon. So transitions down to the n equals 1 state are forbidden here. Transitions down to the n equals 2 state, I don't see a problem there. Maybe I can find a higher energy level here that when I drop down to negative 3.4, the change is 3.02. It seems reasonable. And if I look at the n equals 3 state, negative 1.51 EV simply isn't a big enough number where I could drop down from a higher energy state to the n equals 3 state and have that be a 3 electron volt energy transition. So transitions down to the n equals 3 state are ruled out. Even if I went from a very large value of n down to n equals 3, that would only yield about 1.5 electron volts for the photon. So I know for sure I'm looking at a transition down to the n equals 2 state, and that simplifies the search. Certainly if I drop from n equals 3 to n equals 2, that's not a 3 electron volt transition. N equals 4 to n equals 2, that's not enough. That's not 3 electron volts for that transition. So we just start writing down the next energy levels. I'm going to start with 5 and 6 and so on, and we're going to keep checking to see if we get the right number. So the n equals 5 energy state is negative 0.544 EV. If we look at the difference between this and the n equals 2 state, this gives me an energy transition of about 2.86 EV. So that's not going to do it. Then we look at the n equals 6 state. That gives me negative 0.378 EV. If I look at the difference between this and the n equals 2 state, I arrive at the transition I was looking for. If an electron transitions from the n equals 6 state down to the n equals 2 state, the difference in energy is 3.02 electron volts, and the photon that's emitted from that process will carry away the 3.02 electron volts of energy. So to write down our final answer, that photon we observed must have come from an initial n of 6 and a final n of 2. And that's it. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.